The reasons are seemingly endless. Why I would choose a mid drive over a hub drive every single time, except for one very specific instance. Dun, dun, dun. I get asked this question all the time. It's like, hey, will you install a hub drive on my bike? And I always ask, like, sure, but why do you want a hub drive? And they're usually like, I don't know, what's the difference? And I'm gonna break down the differences now. And hopefully I'm gonna debunk a lot of myths or a lot of like misconceptions that people have about mid drives and hub drives. So I wanna go down the list and compare pretty much side by side the pros and cons of each one. And I'm gonna be using a Bafang 750 watt hub motor, and I'm gonna be using a 750 watt Bafang mid drive for my examples on this one. As close to an apples to apples comparison as you could possibly get. Same manufacturer, same wattage. We'll go down the list of what makes each one different. All right, if you're new to this channel, I'm Johnny Nerdout. I've been a professional e-bike mechanic, converter, builder since 2017. I've worked for a few different e-bike manufacturers and different custom shops before I went off on my own and started doing it on my own. So I have a decent amount of experience, probably more than the average bear. If that gives me some credibility, I'll take it. All right, so let's start, shall we? All right, so first I wanna start with performance. This is, for me, one of the biggest ones. Hub motors just, they can't keep up with a mid-drive. First of all, hub motors are rated at 80 newton meters of torque, whereas a mid-drive is rated at, depending on where you get your spec sheet from, 120 to 160 newton meters of torque. That's double. That's twice as many newton meters of torque. If you've ever driven in a car that had 150 foot-pounds of torque and then driven in a car that had 300 foot-pounds of torque, you would appreciate that difference. It's crazy. It's a big difference in performance and what you're getting. Even though it's the same rated wattage, it's still drawing the same amount from your battery. It's just using it so much different. It's like having that kind of different torque in your car, but getting the same gas mileage. But really what it comes down to is how that power is applied. Mid-drive comes from the crank and it uses your gears in the back like a transmission. I'm gonna use this car analogy as much as I can here. It uses those gears in the back. So essentially you have an 8-speed transmission in the back. Whereas with a hub motor, you have 1-speed transmission. So it's like being stuck in third gear in your car. So if you only had one choice but to be in third gear in your car for all purposes, highway driving, climbing hills, starting from a red light, that's what it's like having a hub motor. The acceleration is gonna be really slow. You're not gonna really be able to climb hills very well. It's gonna be all right around like mid-range, mid-gear, it's gonna be fine. And you know, towards the higher end, it'll be okay. But it's just not nearly as effective way to use a motor versus using gears to like really dial in and use that power where you want it. So a mid-drive is gonna outperform a hub motor across all speed levels. Low end, climbing hills from a start, all the way through to top end. It's using a more efficient gear ratio. So it's gonna have a higher end top speed and a better lower end. And here, I'll insert a clip here of same bike that I converted from a hub motor to a mid-drive using the same battery and everything, just switched out the motor. And you can see the difference between hill climbing and top speed. So you can see how just using the gear ratio makes a world of difference. And also just to put a finer point on that is think about what that does. If you only had third gear on your car, think about what that's doing to your motor. Like it's a lot of strain on your motor, just like on a hub motor. You wanna find that ideal range to keep your motor in the best health that it can. When I used to work as a e-bike mechanic at a shop that we only sold hub motors, we would get so many bikes in with burnt up hub motors and we would replace them. We'd get bikes sent back into us from our dealers of burnt up hub motors. Because if you ride a bike hard or if you don't really know what you're doing and you accidentally ride it hard, you're gonna burn up your motor. Motors don't like to get a lot of amps or a lot of power sent to it without spinning real fast. And with hub motors, you have no choice but to send a lot of it. You're putting a lot of strain on it. Whereas with a mid-drive, obviously, you could put it in your lowest gear and that motor's spinning, and that's what it likes. I would easily say I've seen a 10-to-1 ratio of burnt up hub motors to mid-drive motors. All right, the next myth I wanna talk about is reliability. This is a common myth that I hear a lot about, especially from you hub drive fanboys, and you know who you are. This is just nonsense. It's the biggest misconception I think there is reliability, that hub drives are more reliable than mid drives. Because, oh, if you snap your chain, you're not getting home. But if I break my chain in my hub drive, I'm still getting home, which is true. But that's why I just carry an extra $15 chain in my pannier bag at all times. It takes up no space. And in the off chance that I happen to break my chain, which I've only broken a chain probably twice in the last 3,000 miles of riding that I've done. And that was more my fault because it was me climbing hills, giving it full throttle, which I have a BBS HD motor. So it was putting over 1500 watts of power on that chain and climbing a really steep hill. That was more my fault. I've only broken two chains. And that's only $15 part that I could fix on the side of the road in under 5 minutes. But what hub motor people don't like to talk about is their fatal flaw. You know what I'm talking about. Let's think about how power gets from the motor to the tires. The only thing that's holding it together are spokes. These little tiny spindles of steel or aluminum, whatever ones you're using. Those things work themselves loose. Hub motors work spokes loose. I don't know how many times, if I had a penny for every time that I've had to replace a spoke on a hub motor, I'd have at least $10. I've had so many people bring in a hub motor that is just shredded, that they had to like walk in, left them stranded. You can't repair that on the side of the road, unless you happen to be packing in extra spokes, extra nipples, and a wheel truing stand, which nobody does. And it's much easier to get a chain fixed. Anybody's gonna be able to replace that. How expensive it is to get a rear wheel built with a hub in it. A lot of bike shops won't even touch it. They're like, oh, I don't know what this is. They don't feel comfortable doing it, or their business license doesn't cover that. So yeah, and it's very time consuming and expensive to replace spokes, get a whole hub motor wheel rebuilt and trued. Whenever I see a customer bring in a hub motor bike, if I check the spokes on that motor in the wheel where the motor is, so many times there's loose spokes in there. They're just waiting to fail. I would much rather replace a chain than get a wheel rebuilt. Easy, it's so much easier. So reliability, I say, goes to mid drives. All day, every day, twice on Sunday. All right, now let's go to price and aesthetics. Price, generally it's gonna be the same price. We're talking about within 50 bucks if you wanna get a 750 watt hub motor or a mid-drive. Mid-drive comes as a kit, comes with everything, motor, controller, everything. A lot of times the hub motors, you have to just the wheel is, you know, quite a bit less expensive, but then you also have to buy the controller and everything else. So it ends up pretty much costing the same amount, within 50 bucks. But aesthetically, mid-drives, the Bafang, the controller is built into the motor. So it's all a nice, sleek package. With a hub motor, you have this nasty brick of a controller that you have to somehow try to mount somewhere and make it look nice, if you care about that at all. It's a pain. And also, it's less surgery to your bike. You don't have to get rid of your whole rear wheel. You're getting rid of your whole wheel. You have to either throw it in the garbage, donate it, or hang it up in your garage for someday that you're totally gonna reuse it on a different bike someday, but you probably never will. With the mid-drive, all you're doing is removing the front crank and you're losing your front derailleur. That's it. And then it just slides right in place. It's much more cohesive and it looks more slimline. As far as rideability, I'd say that this also goes to mid-drives. It's a much more natural feeling. You get to set which power level of assist that you're putting in. And all they're doing is just adding to whatever you're doing to a bike. So it's just like riding a normal bike. Hub motors have a way different feeling. It can be nice if you're not used to riding a bike, because it's nice just having this little like, this little bit of power kind of float behind you like a little cloud and add to it. But if you've ridden a bike, or if you want to get back into biking, or you know, you give it a little bit of a learning curve, I think you'll find that it's more enjoyable, because it's just like riding a bike. It's just adding a little bit of more power to you. So it makes it more enjoyable. It reinforces the basic fundamentals of riding a bike, being in the right gear, you know, and it's just gonna make your bike last longer and reinforces good fundamentals. Who doesn't like fundamentals? It's fun. Okay, now here is the grand finale. The only time that I would ever choose a hub motor over a mid-drive. And that would be if I was ever using a single speed application, like a motorcycle conversion where I didn't have a chain ring in the back or a cassette or something like that. Or if I was doing just a single speed bicycle conversion. But the one caveat is I would wanna make sure that it was like a higher speed motor. Like if I was doing 3000 watts or more in that hub, then the differences start to become less and less. That gap, performance gap, starts to get less and less. When you start getting to like 10,000 watts, the performance level starts going down. When you higher the voltage, higher the amps, like electric cars, they all use hub motors. They're using units of 400 plus volts going through it and enormous amounts of amps. That's why you get Teslas that are doing 0 to 60 in under 2 seconds, because they're just putting gobs of power to it, and they have, you know, 3-4 motors, one per each tire. It's just throwing so much power to it that it doesn't really matter at that point. But when you're using an e-bike and you're using low power, like under 1,000 watts, you can totally tell the difference. It's night and day. So if I was ever to do a motorcycle conversion, I would probably use a hub motor, because at that point there's not much difference and it'd be a lot easier to convert. That's why I only do mid-drives, and why I would only recommend mid-drives to anybody ever thinking about either buying an e-bike or converting an e-bike, is unless you're getting a screaming deal, like someone's selling one for like $200 or $300. If you plan on riding an e-bike at all, just get a mid-drive. It's way more fun, way more enjoyable, way less of a headache. It's just the way that it, that's the future. Hub drives were cool 30 years ago when that was the first, they were the first technology, and it's an old technology. Mid drives are, yeah, as of this, they're like 10 years old roughly. They're the new technology, and they finally got to the point now where they've worked out all the bugs, or most of the bugs. It's way better, way better. So I beg you, mid drives are the future. They make e-bike riding so much more fun, you won't regret it. And stay tuned, I'm gonna be putting out another video about my thoughts on dual hub motors versus a mid-drive. Later, guys.